Hey there! If you're unfamiliar with enterprise Java or unsure where to get started, this video is where you want to start. I'm creating another series on more advanced enterprise Java topics, and many of those lessons will involve running Java in a JE container. One of the easiest containers to use is the Wildfly application server from Redhat, so that's what we're using. There are four things you need to do to get started with Wildfly before you can take advantage of future Java enterprise videos on DeegeU. So, let's go! The first thing to do is to show you how to get Wildfly. You can download Wildfly from wildfly.org. There should be a big banner that says, download it now, and that's what you want to click on. If they don't have a big banner like they did here, go to the download button on the menu at the top of the page. There should be many versions listed. Some will have alpha or beta at the end. You'll want to avoid those, unless you like living on the edge or think that the next version of Wildfly will be released by the time that you need to go to production. There are some listed as CR. Those are releases, and you should be okay to develop with those. They usually move quickly to final when they're in CR. The last one is ones that say final. Those are definitely okay to use in production. For these versions, I'm pulling down Wildfly 9. Each lesson on DeegeU that uses an application server will specify the actual version used, but I'll also be clear if we're using something that isn't in an earlier version. There are several versions of the application server as well. There's the regular distribution, the servlet-only distribution, and the source code distribution. We're using the regular distribution. It says application server distribution. So step one, download the zip file by clicking download. Okay, we've downloaded the file. You now need to know how to install it. Once you've downloaded the file, you'll need to unzip it. Unless you're on a Mac, then it's already unpackaged for you. Create a directory where you want Wildfly to reside. I usually create a directory called Wildfly. Then I create specific version directories under it. This way you can switch between versions if necessary. Create your directory and move the unzip directory to your destination directory. That's pretty much it. You now have Wildfly installed. Now we can start the application server up at this point, but to be able to do anything meaningful, we need to create a user first. So the next thing you need to do is know how to create a user. Open a command prompt and navigate to the Wildfly directory. This should be where you copied the folder. The directory for Wildfly should be named something like wildfly9.00.cr1. Inside that directory is a directory called bin. Go to that directory. We'll discuss the rest of the application server directories in another lesson, but this is just to get us up and running. So we need to run the script add user. We type add user.sh on Linux or a Mac. On Windows, you'll run add user.bat. It'll prompt us to enter the type of user we need to create. We need an administrator, so we'll select A, management user. Leave the realm alone. Use whatever username and password you like. I'll use 8 asterisks for the password. We don't need to assign our user to any groups yet. Say yes, we want to add a user. Say we don't want this user to be a slave host. And we're done. The final thing you need to know is how to test everything. In the same directory where we ran add user, you need to run standalone.sh or .bat if you're on Windows. This will start the Wildfly server. Everything should look similar to what you see here. We're looking for the final message that says, everything has started up. That should be similar to this. Okay, now open up an internet browser window. It doesn't matter which one. Go to this address. Use the same username and password you just created, and you should be in the management console. Feel free to look around. There's not too much damage you can do. If you think you're in a state you can't get out of, delete everything and reinstall. It shouldn't take more than a few minutes. So that's it. I showed you where to get Wildfly, how to install Wildfly, how to create a user in Wildfly, and finally, how to run Wildfly. To close Wildfly, just Command-C the process, and that's it. Your computer should be good to go and ready to tackle the Java Enterprise lessons. See you then.